Thank you very much. I would like to, before I start, to thank the organizer for giving me this opportunity to participate in this important conference. And I would like to share with you the quite small number of years of experience, 7 years of experience compared to European countries, more than 100 years of experience in MetroRail. It's really very difficult to speak this morning about our experience because we have really few number of years of experience, but we learned a lot from Europe and from Asian cities who have done Metro a long time ago. So it's my pleasure to share with you this experience and this small presentation which we'll do this morning. So the RTA in 2005 established, we have put a vision for the RTA, safe and smooth transport for all. And also we have a very challenging vision in order to put the legislations for transportations and at the same time make sure that we have the best transport system in the world. The presentation today will be consist of five parts. The last part will be the most important, actually the cream of experience which we have learned through the number of years in which we designed and constructed this longest train, driverless train in the world. The main reasons for establishing the RTA was actually five strong reasons. And the most important one was to build a world-class transportation infrastructure for Dubai to cope for the rapid growth. In addition, we have to have an integrated entity responsible for all safe and transportation requirements, because before we built the RTA, we actually have different element of transportations, different organization agencies. They are not under one umbrella, and it was difficult to coordinate and communicate those small agencies together. And also the congestion problem which we're facing at that time. So we have to come up with innovative organization structures, at the same time implementing transportation projects as fast as possible. The most important challenge was to actually set up a very big organization responsible for everything in transportation, and at the same time you have to find a solution and build up strategic big project to solve those problems. So the challenges, actually it is two challenges. And as you can see, when we have put a set up for the organization as an RTA for Dubai, we have came up with a model in which it is a little bit different than organizational government, typical organizational model. It is actually a commercial and governmental model mixed together. Maybe it is similar to some European cities or Asian cities in terms of the organizational structures. It consists of one commercial agency, four operational agencies, and three sector support and governance. We actually have spent more than $10 million from 2005 till now in order to build these infrastructures. We have done an efficient BT system which can provide and give an option for people to have a competitive mode to private cars. In addition, it is to increase the BT from 10% to 20% in 2020 and to 30% in 2030. So the optimization of this is to have efficient utilization of public transport asset and system, and to have a balanced distribution of travel demand between private and public modes, and greener and more sustainable transport environment. You know, in addition, you have to keep in mind that we are a small city, population is close to 2 million with 200 nationality with different cultures living in a small city, very active city. The rapid growth is very high. In addition, different languages, different cultures, and you want to encourage people to use the BT. It's very difficult, you know, because everybody coming from different country with different system, different culture, different regulations. It's a very big challenge. Public transport challenges, those are the challenges in summary. But the most important thing is the integrations also, as I said, between the land use and transportation planning. That is very important challenge. In addition, to put up the policy and strategy, because as you know, we are new countries and we didn't have that clear policy and strategy in transportations in order to convince the federal government to, you know, it's very difficult, especially for car ownership, for example, just an example, to stop people from owning cars or try to minimize the freedom of having cars, because the car ownership percentage is very high compared to any other city in the world. So it is really not easy. And if you can see, this is the strategical plan for the RTA. And if you, it is divided into three sectors, the community sector and the transport systems. In addition, it is the internal efficiency. So in the three parts, the first one is the integrated Dubai, and then you have Dubai for people. And how do you actually make the road and the infrastructures friendly to people? This is a very big challenge. In addition, to convince the customers, as I said, from different cultures, to make them happy, to encourage them to use the transport. In addition, the other thing is to convince them to leave their car. That's number four. We have to do a lot of programs and initiatives in order to convince people to leave cars and use the metro. Safety and environment and sustainability, also it's important. We have to minimize the impact, adverse impact, environment impact of public and private transport. As you know, the federal government have a lot of federal laws regarding greenery and other laws for the environment, so which we have to abide by. And this is added also another challenge to us. Financial sustainability is important. Advance RTA, develop human resources and others, because as you know, we are a young country. We have to develop the human resources in order to operate and run those projects. The asset sustainability, also it is important to have an asset. You know, we have spent a lot, billions of dollars. So we have to make sure that we have a proper asset management in order to keep them performing well for a long time. Those are the initiatives which actually are we put in mind. A public transport break-even plans, because the government can't subsidize this system, transport system, for some time, but it's not forever. We have to minimize relying on people in long term. So we put a plan for the RTA when the government should be subsidizing these infrastructures. Transportation policy I already talked about, public transport system and services, UAFC and AFM, Wijhati, and those are very technology. We have a unified card. We spent more than 500 million dirham, which may be close to $200 million for to build up a system. We call it NOL. And in this system, you can with one unified car, you can use all modes of transport in Dubai. Integration of different modes, transit-oriented development, and that's very important. Also, bus and taxi dedicated lanes. And those are the initiatives, more than 200 initiatives we have. And these are examples of the project which we had. Break-even plan, break-even will be in 2017, I hope, by increasing the ridership, increase non-fare books revenue from naming rights, retail, others also. The break-even in 2016 through increasing the ridership, increase non-fare books revenues, and increasing the efficiency. And you can see these are the figures which we, when we started, actually, we started with around 5% the ridership for BT. Now we are reaching, for the metro, we are around close to 10%. That's in 5-6 years. We, every day, we carry around 320 passenger by metro daily, 320. We carry about 450 by taxi, and around 350 by buses, and around 30,000 for maritime. So around 900,000 passenger use the transportation system per day in Dubai. Those are the summary. The transportation policies which we have implemented, some of them is local policies, some of them is federal. It's around 43. Examples of policies: SALIC, the road tolls, parking control, carpooling, sharikni. Those are all examples of and others. You know, we are most of them is standard and. Used worldwide, but for us in the Middle East, it's new. But we have added some new technology to them with some touch of cultures, because, you know, even for the, when you see the, if you see the design of our metro, there are classes for women and children, for example, and there are places for handicap and, you know, other facilities. We try to, even in design, implement our touch in the system. Transportation policies, examples of under consideration. These are the policies which we are looking at. Increase of annual vehicle registration fees in order to limit people, because people pay around $100 for registration fees. Per year, which is very cheap compared to any other country in the world, one of the cheapest. So encourage people are encouraged to have cars compared to Japan, Singapore, and other cities. Relating vehicle registration fees to engine and size mileage, incentives for environment-friendly vehicles, registration restrictions for old cars. We have a new coming up, a new legislation law for this. Transit-oriented development, TODs, staggered work hours, car-free areas, streets. We will have cars free in Dubai in the future because this practice is a worldwide practice, and it will help the environment, and we're trying to implement this practice. This is the public transport system services. This is a unified card which I talked about. And it is used for parking and others. This is the NOL card which I talked about, the unified card. In addition, the automated vehicle management, this is the OCC and others, we are using, we have very sophisticated advanced systems for buses and metros also. This is the journey planner, in which you can just, there's a program in which you just put in where you are and where you want to go, and it will give you the destinations with time and cost and everything, through the internet, of course. This is very important. Those this slide is very important. It shows integrations. One is on the federal level for Maidan, for example. One is for the Union Rail, which is we are building now under the federal government is building, which will be linked with the red metro line with Maidan station. This is shows you how we are integrating the federal lines with the local line. And this is another one which shows the integration of Dubai Metro with other BT modes, buses, maritime, and taxis together in Al Qubaybah and Bar Dubai site. So I gave two examples for that. It's very important to have these integrations to increase the ridership. And this is the TOD, and there are good examples. I mean, we learned this from Singapore also. They have the same system, maybe. And many Asian cities, they have some similar system in which they encourage the development around the stations. As a matter of fact, we have done a study. The value of land have been increased by 30% around those stations since we built this metro. These are another examples. This is another case study, actually. This is the bus dedicated lane. We have about 7.6 kilometers of bus and taxis dedicated lanes already implemented. We have 30 kilometers of bus and taxi lanes are planned within the CBD and others. The main result and achievements, those are the achievements which we have. Now, I don't want to go through them all because they are very clear. One of the most important thing is the financial saving in metro and buses. Actually, we saved around 5 billion dirham a year after building this infrastructures. We invested around 10 billion dollar, seven years. But what we are actually saving is a lot. And if somebody asks, how did you calculate this? There is an international question, how do you calculate wasting time and delays and others. And there is the second thing is there is a continuous improvement on the improvement in metro service reliability. And additions, also the satisfaction of metro customers. Also, we have the environment result. You know, most of our buses, of course, the metro is electrical. The buses is we are using Euro 4 and Euro 5. So it changed. It has a big effect on the environment. If you look at those numbers also, availability of main system elements, the train, door, gates, ticket, we are close to target in relation to punctuality and travelators availability. We are very punctual. The train is on time, and really we are very happy and very proud to have those numbers. As you can see, it's up to 99% maybe. Those are the significant exceeds. We exceed targets for the KPIs, for the green line also, and for the red line. And you can see from those graphs that the red and the green service availability and punctuality are approaching 100, as I said. Public transport efficient. efficiency and results, public transport. You can see those figures, I already talked about them, but from 2010 to 2011, increased actual to planned in kilometrage by 1%. We increased load factor by 1%. From 2008 to 2011, decreased accident rate by 75%, increased the OTB by 375%. And those are the numbers which I already talked about them. Increase in ridership around 91 million 2005 to about 190 million in 2011. About 109 growth. And these are the public transport share. Increased BT share from 6% in 2006 to 10% in 2011. Significant increase also by all international practices. If you compare this to any international practice, you'll find it is it's amazing. These are, if you compare Dubai to any other European city, or for example, if you West, what's that? Yeah. Westminster, or I don't know, I can't read this. That's in UAE we are 77%, they are 75%. Other cities also, London for example, 2011 they are 79%. So we started comparing we are benchmarking with other good cities who have a lot of experience and a lot of populations. We are starting to be close to them. Satisfaction levels range from 82% to 97%. This compares excellent with well-established international city. Also, if you see those cities, you'll see UAE doing a good job among them. Satisfaction bus customers, 68% satisfaction, needs improvement, I'm sure, because it's... we built air-conditioned bus shelters, and that because of the weather, you know, we have 6-7 months of hot weather, humid weather. We have done our best in order to encourage people to use. We have done a lot of electronic programs in order also to make it easy for European and others to use the bus system, but a lot of work needs to be done in order to convince people to use buses. Those are the financial saving in petrol and buses. We have around $422.6 million saving. Public transport main result. This is the environment result. As I said, I already talked about this, but if you want the numbers, it is estimated at 2.63 dirham, billion dirham. Transport-related emissions are expected to reduce by 9% from 2010 to 2020 due to the implementation of planned BT projects and transport policies, which I already talked about, and the spec which I already talked about. The environment result, as can be seen on the screen now here, about 1,530 buses are equipped with different types of filter to reduce pollution. And the same others. Thank you very much.